Lee, I can hardly hear it.
Gotta be up at 6.
If I turn it down any more, I might as well turn it off.
There's an idea.
Okay.
Lee.
Did you get a good look at him then?
No. He grabbed hold of me, pushed me up against his car so that I was facing away from him.
Lara, look, I'm sorry, but this is really important. Can you describe him in any way?
He was white, 30s, 40s. That's all I can tell you.
Did he say anything to you?
Swearing at me that it was my fault.
The accident?
He was talking about people.
What do you mean?
Names. Names I'd never heard of. He was talking very quickly, angry. It was making no sense. Then he threw me on the ground.
So he was attacking you while he was saying these things?
He slammed my head against the car.
Do you think that Tom could hear this?
Tom started calling out to me, and that's when it stopped, when he heard Tom.
So he didn't realize there was a child in the back of the car?
Okay, so what happened then?
I don't know.
What are you doing here?
I'm here writing a book.
About the island?
No. It's just easier to concentrate. No internet, phone reception. My PA says it's like I disappear off the face of the planet.
It wasn't about creating brand new technologies from the ground up. It was about using all the scientific, medical, and engineering research we have acquired over the years. It was about the fusion of advanced medical science combined with space exploration technology.
Hello?
Miss Eldridge! Oh, I'm not sure you remember me. I'm your publisher.
Oh, hi.
I wonder if you remember we had a talk a little while back about a deadline?
Yes. The book draft. Well, I'm nearly finished this final chapter.
Oh, have you? Oh, what a clever little girl you are.
No, you won't be disappointed.
I'm already disappointed, Miss Eldridge.
Go on, tell me.
I can't. I don't know anything.
Go on.
Find out how you can see Virgin Radio's...